So hello everyone, welcome to the Expert Matter series of ISBR Business School. Today we have Sayanti Das amongst us. Welcome Sayanti.
Thank you Shruti, thank you very much.
So we have Sayanti Das among us for this video interview of the series Expert Matters. Sayanti has been working with Kyndryl as a content specialist. She has an experience of 14 plus years involving and engaging into various deliveries of content related to technology. She has been a lead tech writer in Ericsson. And prior to that, she was with Deloitte, CA Technologies, and so many other reputed organizations. She has been associated with learning and development, deployment, and sales enablement. So, Sayanti, can you please share your experience regarding technological writing amongst us?
Thank you, Shruti, for giving me this platform. And I'm delighted to share my experience. Thank you, everybody, for listening to me. So it happened very, very abruptly. Like, you know, I did my humanities. I did my master's in English. And at that point of time, IT industry required a lot of English writers. They badly required the writers for technology related this related, you know,
writers, you mean
documentation. Yeah, so that's how it began. I got into content writing first, then I got a break into tech writing into an ERP organization. Yeah, so then it was an on-job training for me. I did not come from the background. I learned everything about tech writing, how to learn about technology, the entire architecture, about the background, the front end, about a product, an IT product, and then write it for the users. So basically, a tech writer is the one who writes the help files that goes with the product. That is very, very much a required component of deployment. And the admin files, the FAQs, the you know, support docs, all these things comprises a tech writer's creation or whatever you can say.
Okay, so coming from a humanities background, you were able to break down in such intense and hardworking field. I know technological writing is not just writing a content. You need to have a lot of information, a lot of knowledge about it. You have to research, read, learn everything. And so do you think people from any educational background can be a tech writer? So is there any specialized graduation level or any experience, academic degree or educational background you need to have for becoming a technological writer?
So being a technical writer in India, you don't need to come from any specific background. Mm-hmm. Fortunately, there are many countries like USA and all. If you come from different background into tech writing, you have to have a technical writing degree or a certification from a recognized university or institution, and then you will be considered as a tech writer by your employer. But in India, we don't have that trend, we can have a lot of, you know, we can come from any background. Mm-hmm. As long as we are ready to learn technology, as long as we are ready to understand how, you know, how to read, how to do our homework well by, you know, upgrading our knowledge. However, there are certain homework that you can do before you start this career, and that would always give you an edge as the market is competitive now. So the first thing is that you acquaint yourself with the different style guides available in the market. That is the MSTP style guide, the Chicago Manual style guide. That would help you to relearn and restructure your way of writing that you have been doing so far, and the technical way of the format, that the way you have to write. Second thing is that do read the help files and observe them properly. Mm-hmm. For it can be a phone help file, a mobile phone help file, to any software help file that you have. And if you want to take that, just observe how the way they are formatting, how way they are structuring, how they are, you know, creating different scenarios to prepare the manuals. Mm-hmm. And thirdly, there are institutes which do offer certification courses in India on tech writing. And I would recommend going with those certifications. Mm-hmm. Symbiosis offers one. And then there are Udemy courses, paid ones. And there is also ECG, I think it is called. It is a government recognized certification for basically for content writers. So there are plenty others who are offering. So just do a little bit of a market research. These are recognized places from where you can take technical writing certifications.
Oh, wow. So were you a tech enthusiast from the beginning, from your early childhood, or you developed the interest while you were growing up?
Oh, not really, not at all. In fact, I remember before I joined as a tech writer, I used to run away from technology. I mean, I remember I used to take the simplest of the mobile phone, and I never, paid extra for internet connection because I know I have to learn more about, you know, I have to get into the settings and do a lot of things. So I just kept all those things at bay. To learn about even a handset. But everything happened along with the job. I was given a ERP to fall back, and a retail ERP, which has a, you know, all point of sales to inventory to everything, finance, all together in the software. And I had to learn the software. I had to learn the product, different lines of product, and I have to build manuals. I had to learn the tool, documentation tool, to actually write and publish the way it should be done and shipped with the product. And of course, the format, the style. I had to unlearn what I had learned and relearn the technical writing format.
That's really rare, actually, because today youngsters, or maybe everybody, thinks that we need to learn first and then do it. But you took a step that you joined something and then you learned in the process. That is rare, and that is like really appreciative. So
yes,
What are the areas? I was sorry to cut you in between. You were saying something.
No, please continue.
Yes, so I was just asking you, okay, what are the areas of information that you learned through your experience that we should keep in check? Like for the technical writer, for the tech writer, it should be mandatory to have that specific knowledge.
Okay, so the first thing is that it would be good if you take this any of these courses, tech writing courses. You would have a hang of what exactly is expected out of you. The latest trends, practices, exactly is followed across the country, the process, the product development processes that is followed. You will have a wider knowledge of everything. Secondly, I would suggest that, it's very important to get into technology. It's very important to learn about technology. About the domain, about the product line, services. So it's very, that is one thing in IT in general, that you have to keep upgrading your skills by learning. So when you are saying, for example, if you're saying a product, say a cloud infrastructure, then what is exactly cloud? what are the components when you say that cloud architecture or cloud infrastructure, what are the components required? What is cloud versus on-prem? So these are various things that you need to ask yourself and start building your understanding and keep a close contact and relationship with the subject matter experts.
Mm-hmm.
So they are the ones who would, even if you know the best, they are the ones who are doing hands-on job on a daily basis. They will be always doing better. So keep the learning curve always up. That helps a lot.
So you have to, this is a field in which you will have to learn every day, each day, every minute, because technology is ever changing and ever growing. It's not giving a pause.
Absolutely. And the moment, I mean, right from the day one you start your job till your retirement, you have to, if you are into technical IT corporate, you have to keep on upgrading and learning. The moment you feel that I've learned everything, that means you are moving down the ladder. So
you are blocking your growth in time.
Yeah, that portion. Yeah.
Yes. Okay. So what is the role of accuracy you must have in your content?
So the role of accuracy is basically, it comes with the hands-on job you do, the experience that you gather, and gradually, you know, you become more accurate with the content that you're delivering. Firstly, it's the accuracy comes when you know the product. Then how are you going to communicate that to the user? Your end user can be someone from a very highly technical person who would be using, reading your manual or using your manual to actually develop the backend process. Or it can be an end user like me. I mean, I have no knowledge now. I have to run the phone or a camera and something. So so you have to understand the user perspective and accordingly build the deliverables. That can be a marketing deliverable, that can be a technical deliverable, that can be a UI deliverable. However it is, you have to first understand the product, the technology, the services that the organization is upholding, and then the user, and connect that with the audience.
Absolutely.
So I think, yeah, accuracy comes with that and over the time.
So Sayanti, this video series is for management students specifically. So what are the career opportunities in tech writing for management students? If I want to be a tech writer and I have no knowledge about technology or anything, so shall I take a hope for it, take a chance in it?
Absolutely. You know, if you have a knack for technology, please go ahead with it. If you want to build a career in technology, in IT, please go for it. Because technical writing is one area where you have ample scope of writing. You don't have to code. But other than coding, you have to know everything. It's a big myth that you know, the moment you hear tech writing means there will be codes and all these things. No, it is not that. So you don't have to be scared. All you need to know is that get into the field, learn about the different trends that are happening, different technology being used, and how they are communicating, and understanding the overall picture, and you are there. And the best part is that the moment you are into this technical writing field and the moment you come up as a writer over the years, you can mold yourself into different fields. Like, you will be a fantastic writer or a content builder for sales. You will be a fantastic person who can help into instructional designing for learning and training and development. So your scope widens a lot into IT corporate. Yeah.
Now, since it is very growing, it is on a pace of growth. Technical writing is, I think it is a much evolving and growing career.
Yes, yes, absolutely, absolutely. Yes. And also, a lot of, you know, management students who have a engineering background or have been with IT, like into tech support or quality assurance, they can also try this. They will also be having an advantage because they know the functionalities very well and they know exactly what the user wants. So they fit into these shoes very well as well. So that can be like either ways. You can also be a novice. You can also have experience and come to this particular field.
Mm-hmm. So is there any role of soft skills of in the technical writing field?
Not really. This is a completely back-end field.
Mm-hmm.
So in an R&D, you would be mostly, you know, taking the be a part of the entire delivery and the deployment process. I would say more than the soft skills, if you develop knowledge, soft skills help you for any corporate job. So that goes without saying, because you have to be dealing with all subject matter experts like architects, solution architects, management, this, that. So soft skills always help for no matter what job you take up. Second is that it would be great if you know the entire you know, process or methodology that IT follows, like agile methodology or software development cycle, life cycle. If you know these, that would always give you an edge.
Oh, wow. So I think we have opened a very clear overview for the management students and all the students who are hoping to pursue a career in tech writing. I'm really very grateful to have you in this interview today. Thank you so much for taking out your time.
Thank you. And I hope, Shruti, everyone benefits out of this. Mm-hmm. And hope to talk to you soon, very soon. Hope you have a wonderful future ahead. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Really excited to meet you in person, Sayanti.
Sure. I'm waiting too.
Thank you. Okay. Thank you so much.
Take care. Bye-bye.
Take care. Bye-bye.